beneath the surface cannot grow.
The artist named Elisa Edgianto. I don't know if that's pronounced correctly. She's a brilliant Indonesian artist. She has a very specific style. It's very dark and mystic, and all of her pieces are in very, very pure in its expression. So it's
very gloomy.
Yeah, very gloomy. Yeah. The new album cover has references to the aesthetics of our live shows, because the lighting and stuff, it's a lot of background lighting, and then you see the silhouettes on the band on stage, and it's kind of the same in Elisa's artwork. I see it like two objects. You have the background, and it's kind of like a gray veil, and then you have two figures. You have like really big head of a Buddha, I guess, mm-hmm. like representing serenity, and then you have this small, almost like figurine type playing the flute into the ear of the serenity of the Buddha. He shared the thoughts on like the lyrical theme, and so my guess is that it communicated to you, like you have that small voice.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
So it's very distilled. It's nothing. Well, there's no extra information in the artwork.
No,
it's only the things you need.
It's very clean.
Yeah, it's very clean, very puristic, and I really appreciate that kind of art in general.
I think musicians have a lot to learn from theater and from movies, and how to actually build a whole 90-minute show. It's not only about doing the coolest stuff during the whole show, because then it gets boring and predictable, and it becomes flat too if it's on climax through the whole. So it's all about learning how to actually build the show properly, to kind of save some of the good stuff, and to have like some songs can have visuals, others can not have visuals, other songs can be really plain lightning, and other songs can have really like lots of effects and lots of rhythmical patterns, and also kind of there's so much you can do if you just lower your shoulders and think that you don't need to show your maximum in every single song, because then it's not really a show, then it's just a show off. Especially our visuals has just been an ongoing thing, you know, they're just there for the whole show, every song. And it become really just, okay, they're just there. Mm. And then eventually after song number 5, they maybe don't do that much of an impact anymore. Mm. So I think that's like the main thing we're working on, is how to build it and not only have like the same kind of filmed like sequences, and to have
greater like dynamics.
Yeah, greater dynamics, and to have also different kind of visuals, not only normal screenings, you know. No. But
and that will fit the music very well.
I think so. To be able, there is a lot of So I think that's the main thing that personally I learned from this album cycle, is that it's not about only showing your best the whole time. It's about creating an atmosphere that makes you kind of hunger for something, and then once you get to that climax, it will be just way more satisfying. And it's like having the other way around. It's like having if you're doing like full on like the most crazy lightning and visuals through the whole show, it will be like having a car chase through a whole movie, you know. It's maybe cool for 5 minutes, 10 minutes maximum, not even.
Like a Jason Statham movie.
Yeah. But then you grow tired of it, you know. Imagine if the whole Game of Thrones was The Long Night, for example, that would have been a bit too intense. Yeah. So it's all about portioning out the good stuff.
Yeah.